السلام عليكم، انا دكتوره مروه عباس، بروفيسور اوف كلينيكال توكسيكولوجي زجزج فاكولتي اوف ميديسن. ماي بروجكت واز اباوت امبلمنتيشن اوف فورك بليس بيست اسسمنت ان كلينيكال توكسيكولوجي فور ام اس سي بروجرام. الجانت شارت بتاعي كان بيبدا فيرست 2 مانثس جانيوري اند فيبراري بريباراتوري ستيبس فورميليتنج ا تيم فروم كلينيكال توكسيكولوجي ستاف. ذس اوريدي دان، وي ار now with the steering committee for this project, 5 staff members. And already we have in my department, forensic medicine and clinical toxicology, we have a committee for formative assessment for postgraduate students 5 years ago. So I recruit this committee, I'm the head of this committee, to be the steering committee for my project, for IRB approval, and for maintenance and sustainability of my project. I incorporate my project as a part of the annual departmental improvement plan, and my department council approved it. Then I moved to the second phases, which include training needs assessment and assessment of students and staff members awareness about work-based assessment. And actually, the methods or terms were more or less not they are not familiar with it. And another important thing, the traditional awareness of clinical assessment for postgraduate students, including the final clinical assessment. And formative was done as written exam only. So I designed a workshop done before Corona pandemic on early March, including 20 staff members to be trained about workplace-based assessment. Based on the training needs assessment and awareness assessment العمل للstaff members well, postgraduate students, my team designed a training package including workplace-based assessment, and staff members give a constructive feedback. This is one of the deficiency gaps analyzed from the training needs assessment done. Already this workshops done on early of March for 20 staff members and for 5 postgraduate students, master degree. Then we can name it like for practice, we in my skill lab invite trained staff to perform practical, but as a part of training for using one of the workplace based assessment, which is mini CX for 2 competence only, which is history taking and clinical examining for the 5 postgraduate students master degree. Then this feedback from this formative assessment was analyzed and a report submitted to department council, and my department council proved that this method will be used before a summative exam, and student performance, if not satisfactory, this will they can't be able to join the summative final exam. Another important thing that we use the mini CX checklist by GMC, tailoring it for clinical toxicology, and select competencies, as I told you, tell you before, which is history taking and clinical assessment. Following this, we design an assessor guide to be and printed, submitted to the department staff members to guide them during using MinCX as a formative assessment. Actually, done until April or March as a department meeting in my project, we planned to implement MinCX during June before summative exam. And actually, this can't be done because we have in my hospital, my poison control center closed for about 2 weeks, then transferred to another not prepared, not well prepared place. And some turbulence in the workflow making it difficult to implement this formative assessment for postgraduate students. So to overcome these difficulties, I do modification in my project plan. My team search about the workplace-based assessment and another important concepts or what is called an intrustable professional activity. When we search and find that these intrustable professional activities not well established in my specialty for clinical toxicology. So we hold online meeting from June up till now, define the milestones for master degree students, and each milestone divided into specific tasks that will be observed during formative assessment. Based on this meeting, we modify, but still not final, the checklist for MinCX and the assessor guide. And thank you.